What is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to teach you how to get the areas of any spaces you've created in SketchUp. I imported a model from the 3D warehouse here. It was modeled by Jonathan E. There'll be a link in the description below. It's a really cool sort of modern mobile home, and so I'm really sort of into that. And there are three different areas here. There's an entrance that comes into here, and then there's a bedroom, a bathroom, and a living room. That's what I'm assuming these spaces are based on not having more information. I guess this could have been the kitchen, but it looks like there's a TV in there. So I'm going to assume that when you come in, this area here is the kitchen. What we're looking to do here is get the areas of these four spaces. And you can do that a few different ways. The first way, if you just want to sort of write these down, is that you can actually look at the entity info. So by select any face in SketchUp, the entity info will show an area here. So you can see this has, this space is about 470 square feet. But there is, when I look at this, it's including all of this. And if I just want this kitchen area, I don't want to have that. So obviously you could draw another shape here, but I'm going to show you a way that you can get the right area without having to redraw. Just for reference, you should know that there's a section cut that I put through here, so this doesn't actually look like this with this black line. I'm just cutting through with a section, and I did that with tools and section plane. If you press L, that'll give you the line tool, then you can close off this door here. And because I created a section, there's also another line that's connecting with this that's completing a face. So I'm just going to delete that face and then click on this and hit hide. Now you can see that when I select this, I have a much smaller area because it's just selecting that face and I'm not seeing that line in my model. So it sort of gives you the best of both worlds. The way that I've always done my areas is the space itself. If it's not a part of the space, it doesn't count. So you shouldn't be including any sort of like doorways or these steps because they're not a feature of the space. So here quickly, I'm just going to close off all these doorways. And then delete the faces that are inside. And then I'm going to select them. I'm hitting a control here as I select just so that I just have the select and not deselect. I'm going to hide them. So you can see I could go through here and get each area of each space and have the area appear. You can also get areas by using the text tool or the leader tool. If you select that tool and select on any face, by default it will show you the area of that face. So you can see that matched the entity info that we had before. Now, something that's important here is that when you click off of that, it'll stop your the ability to add text directly into this, at least the formatting for it. So if I type kitchen here, I can't return that. If I select off, it'll show it. I can't add a space or a return, a paragraph, essentially. You have to do that the first time around. So if I select this, and then come in here and type kitchen, and then hit return, you can see that I get that stylization, or I get that return, the paragraph. So that's sort of the way that you have to do it the first time. This isn't a dynamic area, so if I do change this in any way, like if I change this to here, I know that looks wonky, but it's not dynamically linked to the area, so that's just something to be aware of as well. Now, the last thing is that the formatting of this, I think, is not my favorite. And if you actually select this, you can see under Entity Info, it comes up. There's this little thing called Advanced Attributes. You can change this to like a dot and the way the leader is hidden. You can also change the font. So I'm going to change this to something that's maybe a little bit more handwritten. So you can see, and that's more legible as well. When I make a new leader, you can see that the formatting didn't save. The way to solve that is to go to Window, Model Info, And then under here where it says text, you can change the leader text here. I'm going to go ahead and change that, find my text. You can change it there. When we're in the model info window, we want to change something else. You can see that the area here is very specific. And with areas, you don't want to be that specific because it leads to a level of understanding that just isn't there. And areas, depending on where you go, where you take your measurements from, they're not going to be accurate, and how it's built is going to be different. So what we want to do is change this so it rounds it to the nearest whole number. And even that still, typically I'd round it to the nearest increment of 5, is what I always do. But for this, we're just going to do it to the nearest whole number. So if you go to units here, you can see it, where it says format, architectural. We want to change this to decimal. Change inches to feet. And now where it says precision, we want to change this to 0. Then we can exit out of this. Now, when we make a new leader, you can see that it has that formatting that we had before, and it has rounded the number to the nearest whole number. So if I change this to living room, you can see that that I can do this for all the spaces. And then if you'd like to edit this text, like I don't want this, I just want to round it, just come in here, click on the leader, and click towards the bottom. And then you can change the text in here. So I'm just going to change this to 8. And if you hit enter, nothing will happen right away. You have to click out of the leader and the change will be made. I'm going to do this for the last 2 rooms. Bedroom. Bathroom. Some of the leaders may not be exactly where you want them to be, but you can move them. So if I select down here and I hit M for move, I can drag the end of the leader. I can't drag the point of it, but you can use your arrow keys to lock to axes if you want to change its location. There you go. Hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.